The Edmonton Oilers double up on the Dallas Stars on a Wednesday night and end a three-game skid in the process. Tony Brar here alongside Ben Scrivens. As Ben, we saw a different-looking lineup deployed by head coach Jay Woodcroft. Of course, the top story was that McDavid and Draisaitl were centering their own lines, but it was the line of Ryan Nugent-Hopkins, Klim Kostin, and Matthias Janmark doing a bulk of the damage tonight.
Yeah, my sense of it is that Woodcroft saw the lineup for Dallas. I guess he's not going to see it ahead of time, but probably got a sense that Jamie Benn was going to be on that third line. He wanted to line up his heavyweights down the middle with Edmonton not having the luxury of last change, won't be able to line match. Puck possession off faceoffs becomes such an imperative. That's my sense of why these changes were kind of concocted in the coach's office. And the benefit being this third line really took the game over. They basically win it themselves, scoring half the goals, getting the majority of the output offensively, and really having a solid game start to finish.
And Matthias Janmark, of course, choosing the right time to burn his old club.
Yeah, he really had a great outing tonight. Put himself in good positions to score. He obviously scores an empty netter, but he positions himself in a way, he works his way through the neutral zone to give himself a shot at the empty net, really ice it. Previous to that, he goes to the hard area, goes to the back door, around the net, and gets a great pass from Klim Kostin. He really just played a solid game start to finish.
And Ryan Nugent-Hopkins also continues his hot play. He now has 16 points in his last 10 games with a three-point effort on this night. All three players combined for 8 points in tonight's 6-3 victory. Now, of course, today marked the first start for Stuart Skinner since signing that contract extension on Monday. He was excellent for the Oilers as well.
Yeah, he did what he needed to do in this game, which is not try to do too much. Obviously, you have some excitement. There's some good feelings, some good mojo running through your veins after you get a commitment from your team, from the front office in a three-year contract. What you don't want to do is try and do too much. And I thought he did a really good job of playing within himself. He had great defending in front of him. They killed penalties really, really well. And really, the only shots that beat him were picture perfect. There's a tip by Sagan that's right in the top corner, right at the start of the second period. I mean, it's another picture perfect shot, and a 2-on-1, or kind of a 3-on-2 that turns into a 2-on-1. That's just a long pass. It's a long way to travel. You know, if those are the only ones that are going in on you night in and night out, you're giving your team a chance to win, and that's exactly what he did today.
Every W contributes to 2 points in the standings, but tonight was a little extra special with the dads in the building.
Yeah, these family trips, sometimes it's the mom's trip, sometimes it's the dad's trip, sometimes it's a guardian or someone who's been impactful to that player who's tagging along. And tonight was the second game of a road trip with the dads, and some other, I think Nugent's brother was one of the others among this group that traveled with the team. It's such a fun opportunity. They get to see what life is like on the road. They get to really experience. I mean, they're doing pregame meetings. They're doing pregame skates. They're in the building there. I don't think they geared them up to actually skate with them. But they really get a sense of the nuance of what life is like for you as a player. It's a great window into some empathy, some understanding of what we go through as players. And truly, it's a great opportunity to just share how special it is to play in the NHL with people who have been so impactful in your career.
Well, the Oilers' magic number on this night was seemingly 18. Ryan Nugent-Hopkins scored his 18th of the season. Number 18 himself, Zach Hyman, also contributed on the score sheet with the Oilers' lone power play marker on this night. And of course, the Oilers pick up win number 18. They return home to host the Vancouver Canucks on Friday night at Rogers Place before heading in to the Christmas break.